Hello students and friends, welcome back to my session on Arduino in 21 days. We are on day 10. In today, we'll see about a servo motor control program. Okay, so as usual, this is the Nano V3 board that we'll be using. Here, I am using only two pins, the digital pin 2 and digital pin 3, pin number 5 and pin number 6, digital D2, D3. Okay, now part list, Arduino and line follower sensor I used. The line follower sensor in all the robotic classes, they use the line follower sensors that will differentiate between the black line with the white background. Okay, it has three pins actually, VCC connected to 5 volt, ground connected to 0 volt. Sometime they print, they would have printed it as out or S for signal, or in for input. Okay, connect that to D2 pin in Arduino. Then here I used SG90 servo motor. So servo motor also has three pins actually. So you see, this is my line follower, this is the line follower. So this three pins are there. So I think this may be VCC, this is ground, this may be the output. Okay, so let me check. Yeah, this color is the out or the signal, D3 pin, and the yellow color is a ground, and this brown color is 5 volt. Okay, so this is the line follower, typical line follower that I used. So here there is a variable resistor. If you turn either anti-clockwise or clockwise, you can set the sensing distance. You can set the sensing distance. Okay, so this particular line type follower is it is a low trigger. By default, it will be always on the high side. Once it gets the signal, once you move the hand closer to the sensors, the emitter detector set, then only you'll get it is a triggered. It is a low trigger. I said already in some of the sessions in Arduino, but again I repeat, some line follower may work as a low trigger one, some may work as a high trigger one. Okay, this is a low trigger. Okay, I'll tell you later how to use this particular thing in a program later. So this is the Arduino board. Then this is the servo motor that I used. It is a SG90 motor. SG90S. Okay, so you can use a bigger motor also. This motor has three wires, so they follow some different color codes. One manufacturer will sell the part or the product with the different wire colors. So now you see, if the wire is brown or black, that is to be connected with ground. If it is red, the red wire to be connected to 5 volt. Then the third wire may be yellow in color or orange in color or white in color. In our case, it is orange in color. It is orange in color. There is a signal pin. Here it is D3. D3. If you see that, so the orange one in turn, this orange here, it is again connected to white wire here. See, this white is connected adjacent to this violet color, so it is D3. So this is D3, this is D3. Okay, so that is how the connection is. Then we'll see the program. So this is the program. The include file required for the servo motor based projects is servo.header file. So probably this would have been installed already along with the IDE Arduino software. Otherwise, sketch, include library, manage library, then in search servo, enter servo built in by Michael, some persons, this has been installed actually. Okay, So if it is installed, it will be shown in different color. Otherwise, it is in black color only. So since it is in red color, a color difference is there. That means it is properly installed. Okay. Then servo, my servo. I used only one servo. So the name of that servo in this particular project is my servo. It can be any other name also. My servo one. If suppose we are using say more than one servo, servo one, my servo one, my servo two, something like that. Then button pin is the input switch. That is the input signal is obtained through the line follower. The servo pin, D3. So third pin of the servo motor. Then I used a position as one integer variable. The switch flag is very important. Okay, I think this kind of switch flag will not be available in any of the programs available in the net. Of course, I copied this main content from the internet only, but I made some changes after copying from the internet. Okay, so software flag, the end value is 180, so it has to be turned through 180 degree. So then 180 degree instead of 180, if you put 135. Otherwise 90 means only quarter revolution. It is a half revolution. This particular servo motor cannot turn more than 270 or so. Precisely speaking, it turns only 180 degree. Okay. Then it has two blocks: servo block, loop block. Servo block and loop block. Let us see the servo block. So servo pin is number 3. So this is my servo is attached with the servo pin. The servo pin is D3. Then pin mode for button pin is input. That will attach the input. Then my servo write 0. 0 means it will go to home position. So all the servo motor has got home position. So that has to be brought to the home position. Okay. Why? You suppose say you are using the servo motor while using it suddenly the power goes off, so the motor will be at in between. We do not know the angle, okay, at the time of power failure. So it may be at some angle. It is neither 0 or nor 180. So after power is resumed, so in the setup, it once it reaches the this particular line, then the servo is brought to its home position 0 degree. Okay, so after that only it is better to have some command. Now come to the loop. Now I used whenever this button pin senses a low signal, that is once you move the hand closer to this one, now you see. Let me close. Now you see in action, if it is close, it is turned. Okay, so for that it reached here. It is a low trigger, I said, you know. Since this device is a low trigger one, I used low. Otherwise, if it is a high trigger one, instead of low, type high. This low and high must be in capital letter, okay, in caps, because this program, Arduino program, the C language is a case sensitive one. Then I use the switch flag also. Okay, I'll tell you later why I use the switch flag. If both these conditions are met, then only the content in the inside the bracket will be executed. So once it becomes true, then the first line of execution is, now it sets the flag from 0 to 9. Okay, then there is a delay of 0.6 seconds. Again it checks whether the button is low or not. Why I did it so, you know, sometime now after putting it can be, now I see in this particular case it is hand is removed. Okay, that should not happen actually. So for that only I again introduce a low once again. Once this is triggered, there are two for loops. one for loop for the forward rotation of 180 degree, that is end value. Here is it already the servo motor position is at zero, so it starts from rotating from zero to end value. What is the end value? End value is 180, that means 180 degree in step of one with a delay of 2 milliseconds. So my survey position will be keeps on changing from 0 to 1 to 3. This loop will be executing till 180. Okay, so once it reaches, this loop is over, then there is a delay of 0.8 seconds, then it turns in the other direction. Suppose here, say for example, it now let us see the direction of angle of rotation. From this point of view, anti-clockwise. So this one is for anti-clockwise. This means, that means this is in clockwise. Okay, once again let me check. Once it is sensed, yeah, from this direction it is anti-clockwise. So after that, this here it is anti-clockwise direction. For then return stroke, the clockwise direction. Here I use a delay of 2 milliseconds. Here I used delay of 1 millisecond. That means the return stroke will be faster. Return stroke will be faster. Okay. Now assume that still you are holding the hand nearer to the button pin. That means the switch flag will be at 9 only. It will be reset only if you remove the hand. If you remove the hand, then the digital read signal will become high. Once it is high, then only with a delay of 0.25 seconds, the switch flag will be reset to zero. Otherwise, what happens, you know, if this is not there, if this is not there and you are inserting the hand permanently, now you see that, now you see there is only one LED glowing here, that is power on for this. Once you move the hand nearer to this, you will get a signal here. That means it low trigger. Now let me move. Now you see another light is glowing. Okay. So now you see, if you keep on holding it this way, then it is always low. That means if you are not having this one, and if it is always low, this will be repeating, this loop will be two for loops will be repeatedly executing again and again and again. That means it will start rotating anti-clockwise, clockwise, anti-clockwise, clockwise, anti-clockwise, clockwise. So that should not happen. That is why I use the switch flag. If it is clear, take it. If it is not clear, you test the program without by removing this one. You just test it, then only you'll come to know. So because see, that is why I use this one. Then more important point here is I set the value from 0 to 9. That means you are holding the hand inside the sensor, but switch flag, instead of 0, it becomes 9. So again, in the next loop, when it reaches here, switch flag should be, if it is 0, then only this will be executed, but it is not 0, it is 9 now. So this will not be executed. Because of that purpose only I introduce a switch flag, and that is very important, right? Then once the hand is removed away from the sensor, then the you get a high signal. Once you get a high signal, the switch flag, SW flag, will be reset to 0. Then it is ready for the next loop. So this is how we wrote a program. Then you see the application of this one. Not only that, is what I used here is a small servo motor. If you have the torque is not sufficient, now you see this is the now because of the COVID-19, we all need this kind of package, right? If you have a big motor with this cam setup, this cam is designed in 3D printer. Okay, in today's session only I discuss about this one, how to make it and all, under the SolidWorks session. Okay, so yeah, I put a delay. the torque is not sufficient. Let me show you the other video. The torque is not sufficient. Yeah, torque is not sufficient. Now if you have a use a bigger motor with a proper mechanical setup, and it will work on in this particular case I used a wall adapter, a 5 volt wall adapter only for this power supply. Even if you have a use, you can use a 9 volt battery also for multimeters and all. A flat battery, 9 volt battery there is, you know, so use that one. That means all these together you can have it as a single package. Then after in a box like thing, you keep everything here, put a heavy motor instead of this one, servo motor, then without touching anything, without pressing the knob by finger or hand, you can move your hand nearer to this one, the liquid soap will be dispensed automatically. So this is how we made this particular program. Again, even in the solid work session also I said the same. See, you are learning about something about Arduino program using different examples, but after some time you should think of developing some projects or some products. So that should be the aim. Okay, only theoretical study alone is not useful even at the student level. Okay, I am here as a professor, so I'm a consultant in developing and giving my ideas and consultancy in making many products actually. So even at student, if you are a student, even at student level, after learning, after gaining some knowledge in even in this Arduino, so try to develop some projects, try to develop some products. That is the view. Okay, so you have this one. So this particular page, I'll be the D10 servo motor control program, the pin connection, part list and connection, then 1, 2, 3, only three things we used, the connections and all. The program, the copied here, so this is available as PDF file and in the link available under the description. Okay, so this program is available in the net, but this thing is very important. This switch flag, you know, this and all, I think it is not available. You have to search a lot. Okay, so I thought I spent some time and some days even to conceive the idea about this one. Okay, see, any problem, any project, any product, you have to find out the logic behind it, or you have to set the logic for that. Okay, achieve that logic through the program. Okay, so I hope you understood this one. Okay, if you understood, well and good. Otherwise, play it once again, so you will come to know about this particular program. Okay, so if you subscribe my channel already, well and good. Otherwise, please subscribe my channel and inform this to others also, so then they also get some information from my sessions actually. Okay, thank you.